Good morning, I'm Regina, and I will also be covering gymnastics at ECC.
And you're a senior.
And I'm a senior. So skills we taught regarding gymnastics were the forward roll and the donkey kick. The donkey kick is a precursor to a cartwheel. This is all we progressed to within 3 days, since the forward roll took approximately a day and a half, and the other day and a half that we had, we only could progress to the donkey kick. So we understand that children and everyone, we all respond to different teaching styles. So I try to incorporate different teaching styles in order to best teach children. So we incorporated visual, verbal, kinesthetic, social, and solitary. Social and solitary differ in meaning that some people learn better when they're in groups, rather some people learn better when they're taught individually. Typically, kids who are more shy and uncomfortable like to have one-on-one training, and they also typically needed more verbal affirmation. And then again, that was based most on personality, those kids who were, you know, on the separate mat and didn't really want to practice forward rolls with the group tend to need more like one-on-one training. I was assisted by Professor Anderson because I was the only one on the Tuesday-Thursday schedule, which made it very difficult. Using visual, we try to set the example with proficient children, and this really helped other children to participate, because when they saw someone like a four-year-old versus a three-year-old practicing the forward rolls or the donkey kicks, it made them want to try it and prove that they could do it too. And you could hear in the video like the three-year-old saying, "No, I can do that too. I can do that," to a four-year-old who had just previously demonstrated proficiency in the forward roll. Verbally, we talk through the steps, as you'll see in the video, and kinesthetically, we also like guided their body throughout the motion that we wanted them to mimic. So here's an example of Professor Anderson helping teach the forward roll.
Keep your knees bent and in here, and now, ta-da, stand up. That girl, stand up. That's a good job.
Now, teaching the donkey kick, we also use the same type of teaching skills. So we displayed the movement, communicated step by step what we wanted, guided their body from one part of the block to the next part of the block. Children who were more proficient at it also helped teach, and kids who were more hesitant and not comfortable with the movement were taught individually. Here is an example of teaching the donkey kick.
Boom, boom, and look, your hands are still here. And then you go, boom, boom. All right, go. Jump in the air. Yes, 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 that's so good.
As you can see here, she looked toward me, and when she heard that verbal affirmation from Professor Anderson, she lit up. That made her feel really good, which then allowed us to help her even more. So age breakdown, we had a lot of three-year-olds, surprisingly, participate in this. Only two males, and the two boys, they probably stuck around for maybe one or two exercises. They didn't really show very much interest, but the girls, when readily brought out the mats, they just ran toward the mats, and I didn't really need to bring anything. They were already just really into the colorful mats, and they were trying to do like their own side rolls and everything. But once I got one child to start trying the forward roll, that's when a lot of other kids started to listen and try the forward roll itself. There was a big difference between, I say, the three-year-olds and four-year-olds. The four-year-olds showed a lot more development. They showed that they were stronger in the upper body, which was needed for the donkey kick, because with the three-year-olds, once you would try to place their hands on the mat and try to guide them in the donkey kick or just like moving their body off the ground, a lot of the three-year-olds struggled with leaving their hands on the mat because it was just too much weight for their arms. And the males, they didn't really like the forward roll. They were more interested in the donkey kick. So regarding participation, you can see that majority of participation in gymnastics involved the females. More so males, like one more male participated in the donkey kick rather than the forward roll. Here's one of two examples I'll be showing you of children we helped with gymnastics. First one is Avery. She is a female, age 3. Some observations of her, she has a very short attention span. Every time we would teach her something, she would try to run away, and then she would come back, and we'd be able to help her again. She was more interested when we were actually engaging her independently and not having other kids go through also. And she was less inclined to learn the donkey kick, I think, because when we put her up on her hands, she felt less comfortable with her strength to hold herself up. And she also responded really well to verbal affirmation. You'll see on the video. So this is initially, you saw this video, it's the instruction.
Keep your knees bent and in here, and now, ba-dum, stand up. That girl, stand up. That's a good job.
And here, you'll see her do it by herself.
Oh, and stand into a stand. Good job.
And you see that she lit up right after that, once she was able to accomplish the role, and you hear the clap and the good job, she felt really good about it. Her next example is Lucia. She is female, age 3. So out of all the children we had at the ECC, she was definitely the most responsive, the most, she progressed the most out of all the children. And even though she was age 3, she like was actually very attentive. Like I think it's her personality of who she is. She was more receptive to instruction. She liked gymnastics, even though she's never done it before. She showed advanced motor skills. She could actually hold her body while she was doing the donkey kick, and she was able to coordinate her movements, as you'll see in the next video. So this is a short clip of her initial forward roll. You'll hear her say something. She says, look, I can do it. Like, I can do the forward roll, and completely misses the forward roll. Yeah, I can already do it by myself, and just completely face plants. But after we talked through it with her, she picked it up very quickly.
Awesome.
And she just did a double roll out of nowhere. Then the donkey kick.
And now you go. No. Boom. And look, your hands are still here. And then you go. Boom. Boom. Alright, go.
Jump in the air.
Yes! Yes, yes, yes. That's so good. Now, this time.
And this is what she was able to do.
You're gonna come down on this side of the block. Okay? Think you can do that? Try it. So start your hands with you. Okay. Now jump in the air with your leg. You need to stay there. You go boom and then boom. All right. All by yourself this time. Yes. 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 Yes.
So you see, she was actually able to rotate her trunk while getting her legs up, which was a big deal. So the donkey kick. Most of the three-year-olds participated and they were able to get their legs up, but not necessarily rotate their trunks as much as Lucia did. Four-year-olds, they were able to do the donkey kick, but after that they just stopped. They were not interested in it. They were afraid of the cartwheel. We had someone else in the other group. come on over and show them the cartwheel. And once they saw that, they kind of freaked out and ran away. They didn't want to do the cartwheel. They thought it was too scary. And we only had one of the three-year-olds not master the donkey kick. And regarding the forward roll, it's the same. Only one of the three-year-olds were not able to master the forward roll, and that was just because they kept like wanting to like jump into the forward roll. It was honestly a little scary watching them like jump in, like face head first, and they just quit right after that. So yeah, just because of there weren't many males mastering the forward roll. It was only Nico was able to master the forward roll, and none of the males gave any time to learn the donkey kick, so none of the males learned the donkey kick. So how to develop the self-concept. I just thought of using more of the four-year-olds as an example to help develop the three-year-olds. Because once they saw that the four-year-olds would do it, four-year-olds could do it, the three-year-olds wanted to try and do it. And they kind of like looked at the four-year-olds as a role model. And that's what I wanted to do. And regarding self-esteem, you can see whenever the child felt, I guess, confused or kind of discouraged by their performance when they weren't able to perform something like the donkey kick, they would look at me or Professor Anderson for affirmation about what they felt about themselves, like an emotional response. And we would, compliment them, but also tell them what they could correct after that. Like, hey, you did a great job. But let's try to keep your hands on the ground this time. Let's try to keep your hands on the ground. And they would respond more favorably to that. And with self-confidence, we try to build their self-confidence by using verbal affirmation to get them to try again and not give up, like, hey, like, it's okay, like, we can try it again, rather than just giving up. So that's the end of the presentation.
Questions, comments? I think I'm good.
Anybody?